Hey guys, it's Aaron. I want to look at something today that I think I do a lot of during like live models and some of my other modeling videos, but I maybe haven't touched on in a while how, why, what it is I'm doing. And that is, I just wanted to do a quick refresher on working with reference imagery. So the idea here is, I'm not going to go into photo match. This isn't matching photos. This is not using the depth, setting the axes on a photo to match it in 3D space. This is more about just having an image that I want to use as a reference. So there's a couple ways I'm going to talk about loading that in. We'll take a look at those right now. Okay, so in a recent live video, we modeled a boat and I had some reference images. So one of the options you can do with reference images, of course, it's simple, is if you have the setup to do it, is open SketchUp and then also open these other images. So if I was to do something like this, obviously this doesn't work great in my setup. I'm modeling just on my laptop screen here, so losing half my screen to an image and a plan is not ideal. This works real well, of course, if you have multiple monitors, which it seems like a lot of people do nowadays. I could actually have this open over on the other monitor, maybe blown up real big, and this next to it, where I could just kind of turn my head and look at the images, that sort of thing. That works really well. But if I'm in a situation like I currently am, losing half my screen to reference images is not really an option. So now I have to look at some different ways to import those reference images to use them. So you can see there, I actually have two different types of images. One is actually a picture of the boat I'm trying to model. The other is a set of plans. So how I would want to import these would be different based on the type of image. So let's look at two different ways I would import these reference images. The first one's pretty straightforward. I'm going to go to File, I'm going to say Import, and I'm going to grab that plan. And I'm going to import it as an image. I'm going to go ahead and import it, and I'm just going to slap it on the ground, and I'm going to blow it up nice and big so I can reference it. So right now, as I look at it, I'm looking at it down from above, and this is pretty much how I would import this. So this is going to let me come in here and, you know, trace details off of this to use. One note might be to take a look at this and possibly scale or possibly straighten. So what do I mean by straighten? Let's talk about that. So right here, I have a line going right down the middle. You can see that down the middle of the boat. If I come to one end and I click on it, and then I come along the other end. So my red axis should be straight down the middle, but you can see it's just slightly off. And if I look back here, you can see it's actually starts off on this center line, and then by the time it gets to the length of the boat, it's off a little bit. So what I would do in this case is I would draw a line on that center line because it's easier to have a line to snap to. I'm going to do a group select to select both the image and the center line. Then I'm going to go to rotate, click at one end, and click at the other end. Now I'm going to drag that end down till it snaps onto the red axis. That way, as I come in here, I draw a line like this. Look at that. Now it's perfectly straight, perfectly aligned. So any lines that are supposed to align to straight now, I'm actually going to be able to snap straight along there. The second idea is to scale it. So if I have a known quantity, if I know how long this boat is from this point to this point, what I can do is I can draw that line, I can grab my tape measure, and I can click one end to the other end, and then type in the length it's supposed to be. So if this is a 42-foot ship, I can type 42 foot, enter. Do I want to scale? Yes. And now this is to scale. So that is a good tool to have. That's a good way to get that image in. If I was tracing shapes off of here that I wanted to use, that would be the way to do it. My reference image, on the other hand, remember this picture I have right here, this reference image, I don't know that I would want to pull it in and throw it on the ground. This is good because I can trace actual geometry off of this plan. With a reference image like that, I more want to see the details and then hop in and try to copy or replicate them in my model. So the way that I would import that would probably be different. What I would go about doing with the solution that I've come up with lately, especially, is to go into my styles, click edit on my current style, and then click this fourth tab right here, which is my watermark, and load that image in as a watermark. So I'll go ahead and grab that image, hit open, and it's going to start by plopping it right in the middle like this. I can overlay it. Overlay is going to be if I wanted to like show up in front of my model, which I don't really want. I want to be in the background, so I'm going to click on background. That puts my image in the back. It's huge. This is like wallpaper on your computer huge. So I'm going to click next here. I can fade it out a little if I want to. I'd find that I'd start to lose detail if I fade it out, so I generally leave it complete on image. And then what I'll do is hit position rather than tiling or stretching. And then I'll stick it in the corner. So I'll stick it in the top left or lower right corner. And I'll scale it so it's small. It gets small enough that I can still see the detail I want to get out of it, but it's not going to like crowd me, you know? It's not going to crowd my modeling screen. What that lets me do, because I put it in the background, it means if I work on something big, it's not going to get in my way. But if I want to come out like this, I don't need another screen to glance up and see this picture. It's kind of like I printed the picture out and just set it here on my screen, and I don't lose any real estate by putting it in the back to have it there. So there we go. There's a couple ways you can get reference imagery into SketchUp on a single screen using import image and watermark. Like I said, that was something that I kept doing over and over on our live models, and I think I did it in a couple of skill builder videos, and I'm like, I don't know that I've actually touched on what, why, when I do those things. So it does depend on the piece you have. If you're working off of a scaled piece of content, something like a plan, then you may want to import it and scale it and have it on the ground to reference. If it's just something you want to glance up occasionally, having a second monitor is great. That, I mean, I'm not saying don't take advantage. I have a second monitor over there, and if I'm modeling something and I want to see the image, I put it over there on the second monitor. But if I'm traveling, if I'm away from my second monitor, something like that, you can use watermark to pull that image in and still reference it without actually eating up your modeling space. Did you like that video? If so, click like down below, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. We create several videos a week around here, and you'll be notified of each and every one of them if you subscribe. Most importantly, though, please leave us a comment down below. Did you like that tip? Do you have your own? Let us know. We like making these videos, but we like them even more when they're showing something you want to see. Thank you.